hopefully you can see this, because these are two packets of special tiger worms, and this is going to form the basis of my new wormery. Not only will these guys eat through everything that I put into it and turn it into great compost, but they will also produce a liquid feed which will give great nutrients to my plants and my vegetables on my allotment. The main difference, as I understand it, between a composter and a wormery is that these worms are able to eat through not only conventional composting material but also cooked food and also meat within reason. So this is the first stage, and as you can see, if I just hold this one up a bit to the camera, you can see some of them in there. The next stage beyond this is to get my wormery bucket prepped and laid with some starting material, and then I can introduce these worms and hopefully they'll start to get comfortable and start producing me some lovely liquid feed. And here are the other components that I'm going to be using to make up my wormery. I have here a pile of rotting and composting vegetables and organic matter. Well, what I can instantly tell from that is that it's far too moist, so I need to add some more dry material to make that a little bit drier. This is a plastic stand which is going to be raised up from the base of the wormery with some holes in it to allow the liquid feed to pass through it. There's the lid, and here's the actual wormery itself. As you can see, it's not that big, it's classed as a junior wormery, because as you can see from our garden, it's not that big and we haven't really got space for a conventional composter. Now, I mentioned about making this drier. I'm going to reveal to you my secret weapon. Right next to my hand coffee grinder is my paper shredder, temporarily of course, which is going to produce a lot of nice shredded paper to dry out some of that wet compost we've got in the garden. So I've added the contents of my paper shredder onto that, as well as adding a single sheet of paper, can be newspaper, about 5 inches square roughly, just to assure that there is a divide between the two compartments. I'm wearing rubber gloves for the next bit, as you can probably imagine why. I'm now just going to go ahead and mash this all up together and get a nice consistency. So as you can see, I'm just working in a bit of this paper, tearing up a bit, just adding it to it, just working it in nice and thoroughly. The key to it is to have nice chunks so you can let the air get into it, and just to get rid of some of that moisture as well. Now, what's going to have to happen to this is I'm going to put this in to my box here and leave it for a bit and just keep an eye on it and see how it's settling and just work it into it again, just to create a nice habitat for my worms. And then we're going to add the worms to this a couple of days later and see how they settle in. Now, while that's happening, my worms are going to be kept in a dark, dry, not too warm place. So it's coming up to the middle of March now and the weather's settled down nicely and it's quite mild at the moment. So I'm going to use one of my recycling bins to put them in there while this is getting prepped. Now, the worms have come in a breathable membrane, which means they've got a couple of days worth to survive in those bags before they should really be relocated. So what I'm going to do now is just keep on working more paper into this to get it to a nice consistency. It really wants to be around about the same sort of moisture as maybe paper mache or sort of crumbly pastry. Well, there we have it. my worked in compost. As you can see, all those strands of paper, that's a nice consistency, and I've created a lot of lumpy bits for the air to get in. As you can see, we've got one rogue worm there. So this is now going to be placed into my bucket. I've also added a few more bits of paper just to cover up some of those holes, because I have some baby worms coming and I would hate for them to slip through those holes and become part of my liquid feed. So as I said, we're going to leave that now for a couple of days. My new contingent of worms are now residing in here, and they should be fine for the next couple of days while my new compost is settling. So we're going to come back in a couple of days and see what's happened. Okay, so it's a couple of days later, and what I'm doing now is just churning up again. Getting all the way down the side and just pulling it up to get that air in there. And this should be done fairly regularly. You've got to make sure you get down to the bottom and pull it all up, especially down right way down the bottom, just so it doesn't compact itself and get too heavy or waterlogged or stagnant. And it also gives you a good opportunity to say how your compost is progressing. As you can see, mine's going quite well. And also make sure that it's not getting too waterlogged. The second thing you need to do is quite frequently turn the tap. This is from a previous wormery. This is what my liquid feed should look like. Let's see what goes on here. Just tilt that a bit. Okay, as yet we haven't got anything. As you may remember, I left my worms out in here. This is my fresh supply. And they're quite lively, which is great. I'm just going to open these up. Careful not to trap any of them. One. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is just place the contents of this gently on top. And as you can see, there's quite a lot of them in there, just wiggling around. Let's see if I can't show you what I mean. There we go. Now the next, well, I should say final stage of this, is just to put on some ordinary garden waste and then leave this lid open for about 10 minutes or so, obviously keeping an eye on them. Now what that should do is to stimulate them to burrow down and try and get underground away from the light into darkness where they're more comfortable. That should establish them in their new home and should give them an environment which they're comfortable with. And then, like I say, it's just a case of checking them daily, more or less, digging them over regularly with your hands like you saw me doing, and also checking that tap to make sure that you're draining off the liquid. With constant checking, you should be able to see whether there's problems going on, and you should be able to sort any problems out early.